you've woken up in a strange place. You open your eyes. You see a friendly face, and that friendly face begins to tell a tale. Begins to set the scene for a journey to visit the full moon and to see things that you've never seen. So on this night, if you choose to watch this video, it's a journey on which you can go. What I would ask you to do is sit or lay down in your comfy chair or on your bed, wherever you can relax and spend the next 20 minutes or so on this meditative journey of healing, of experience, of sensation. Without any further explanation, what I'd like you to do is to step inside your imagination, in your heart, not your head. It's not about what anybody else has said. I don't want you to think. There's no reason or rhyme. Just an instinct that says step outside your body. Walk out into nature. And as your feet sink into the earth, and you relax fully, take a step into the sky. Follow the sound of my voice up through the atmosphere and up towards this full moon that you can see rising up above you. Travel up, closer and closer, till you arrive on the surface of the full moon. And what I'm going to ask you to do is to keep on moving round until you find yourself on the other side, the so-called dark side of the moon, the side that we never see. It always maintains its position with us. But what about the side that faces into deep space? What about the rest of this distant rocky place? What if you could arrive on the night of the new moon? And gaze lovingly out into space, into a shadow. There's no earth to see, but gradually, as the moon becomes a crescent, slowly works its way over 2 weeks towards being full. Start to get a glimpse of the earth. Get to see it more and more. And in my heart, this gives us an opportunity to experience what it's like to be away from everyone and everything that we love. If you're in lockdown, if you're in quarantine, if you're facing the part of yourself that doesn't take this seriously, if someone you love is ill, but you can't go to visit them, so many things about this seem wrong, but there's nothing to do except the right thing. There's nowhere to go except to ensure you're still getting some exercise and some sun. And as the moon becomes full, as it does tonight, as it was last night, as it will be again tomorrow, the earth comes into full view, and everyone that we love, everyone that we know, represented by this full earth back in view. This is you, this is me, this is all of us, free again. And it may take another moon, or two, or three, before we're free. We may not know for a while yet, but there's no need to live in negativity. There's no need to harbor anger, fear, or pain when it comes to this situation. We've been there before, and we'll be there again. All sorts of new things happen, and old things too. I just want you to know you're not alone. You never were, you never will be. Not if you reach out. Just bathe in the light of the earth that you can see as it hangs in space from this place of opportunity, this chance to make some art, to sing, to dance, to be free at home, free from responsibility, except to those we love, free from responsibility when it comes to work, but shouldering the weight of responsibility of doing the right thing for others. To keep yourself away from others if you're sick, not to spread germs, not to live in fear, but it's clear we need to be sensible. We need to wash our hands and make sure we don't pass things on. But it doesn't mean that we need to change all that much, apart from everything that we've done wrong. Could we start over? Could we go back? Could we go forward with nature? Could we choose to grow more of our own food as a household, as a village or community? Even as a city, and then see the changes that that makes for our country, for our world, for our future. We need to come together, and if we can't to come together physically right now, we can join each other in meditation, we can join each other in conversation, we can reach out, we can give each other a big hug. You don't need to be there. You can contact them using technology. You can write them a letter. Just bathe in the energy of this full moon. Look up. See that light. Let it enter into you. Take on what you need to, but make sure you're getting lots of rest and relaxation and dealing with any stress with humour. And to put it into context, chances are you'll survive this thing. You might lose a friend or a family member. Who knows what this situation's going to bring? Prepare and do the right thing. So slowly come on back. Come back to the earth now that you've been away for a break. Move slowly and silently through space. Fly down from the heavens. Make a circuit of the earth. And look down on every single landmass. See the sea. See the clouds. Feel the positivity. Look inside your heart. Blow away the cobwebs of negativity. Understand that we are still free. It's not an attempt to take our freedom away. It's an attempt to stop us from spreading a nasty bug and making tomorrow anything other than a better day. So are you back? Are you back in your body? Are you back in your room? Do you feel a flicker of anxiety? Do you worry every time you cough? Because I'm going to tell you, you can switch all that stuff off. But it's not the difference between something you think and something you don't think is true. It's the difference between being in your head or being in the heart of you. This is where you live. This is what you give. This is how you get through. No flicker of anxiety here. No lack of generosity of spirit here. All that's here is calm. All that's here is love. All that's here is truth. No fear of failure or responsibility, just the ability to do what's right for you and everyone you know. So enjoy your full moon meditations this evening, whatever it is you're up to. Sleep.